Gentlemen, it's time. It's time for a reboot. You have been sick and tired of the monotonous life. You have been sick and tired of your daily average life. It's about time you restart it. It's about time you reset it. It is about time you reboot your entire operating system. My name is Mangalacharya. In this episode, let me help you do that. Intro. Okay, so the following 5 steps is for everyone who's totally lost, is for everyone who's feeling lost, who's absolutely overwhelmed by the amount of work, opportunities, or the lack of work and opportunities that they're having in their current life. These 5 steps are the steps I use in my personal life to keep resetting and rebooting my life whenever I find myself in a rut or whenever I find myself a little too overwhelmed with the current work. So the very first thing, the very first task that you need to do is declutter the noise. Gentlemen, unfortunately, noise has become a part of our life. Noise has become a very active part of our life. This wasn't the case 5, 10, even 15 years ago, but now it is everywhere. From our smartphones to our laptops to our computers, from the TV, it's just everywhere, especially the social media. I want you to declutter yourself from this said specific noise. If you really want to reboot yourself, if you really want to reboot your life, restart your life and reset your life to your own terms and have the absolute ownership of it, you need to take out a few things that is distracting it the most. You need to take out the most important element or the most unwanted element that is ruining your life, that is influencing your life whether you like it or not. And it's none other than the social media, it's none other than your cell phone. Gentlemen, you can't introspect, you can't look deep into yourself, you can't really think for yourself if you can't declutter yourself from the noise. No transformations can occur if you are absolutely influenced by these things called social media and mobile phone. If you really want to start resetting your life, if you really want to take ownership of your life, first of all, stop giving these algorithms the ownership that they dictate. This is a beautiful tool. The cell phone is a very powerful tool. I'll probably make a video discussing whether a cell phone is a disaster or a boom. But for now, if you really want to transform, if you really want to reset, this is the very first step on your list. Take the time out, put your phone away and get quiet. Get really, really quiet. Get used to the absolute silence and quietness. You can simply sit in your room or a small corner in your house if you don't have a room. You can even come and sit at your office if your office has the access to it. This is what I do in my office. Or you can simply book a hotel room, or you can just go out somewhere where you don't have the influence of the noise around you. Get quiet. Get really, really quiet, because I want you to get used to the fact that quietness and silence is a very powerful tool. Because gentlemen, denoising yourself from the clutter, denoising yourself from all the algorithm and influence you see around, and getting okay, getting absolutely okay with the fact that you can sit by yourself in absolute silence, in absolute quietness, in absolute stillness, and not be worried about this fear of missing out, is the very first step of your transformation. Gentlemen, if you can totally accept, appreciate, and be okay in your silence and quietness, that's your very first step of transformation. So once you have found out a quiet place, once you have found out a quiet corner, a room, or a hotel, the second thing you have to do is stop carrying your cell phone, stop carrying anything that could probably influence you at that given place. I do not want you to think about work. I do not want you to think about relationships, friendships, or anything that there is. I just want you to get quiet, and I want you to unplug from anything that could possibly influence you and your quiet, silent nature. At this point in time, there shouldn't be anything in your mind, and this point in time, you should be totally embracing the silence and the quietness and the stillness that there is. The biggest problem you aren't able to reset your life, the biggest problem you aren't able to restart your life, is because you're too scared. You're too scared of missing out on something. You're too scared to take ownership of your life. You're too scared to break the chain that this social media or this influence around, the algorithms around, have built for you. If you really want to reset your life, you have to start breaking the chain first. You have to restart your system away from the chain first. The chain of events that happens from the very moment you get up. The chain of events that these apps feed you from the very moment you go to sleep. This cannot be a transformative step. This cannot help you attain your personal freedom, your absolute awareness of your true self. So first, find a quiet place to plug out all the social media, plug out all the electronics, plug out every influence that there is. No reach, no availability, no access, period. Step number 3, or process number 3, sit down, lie down or shut your eyes and relax. Now this is going to take a while. This is probably going to be the longest and the most time consuming step of the process, because you haven't ever done this in your life. You haven't ever sat by yourself and done literally nothing in your life. You have always been in the move. You have always been thinking something or the other. You have always been overthinking something or the other. This is a time when you'll absolutely do nothing but just sit by yourself and be lost in your thoughts. It'll probably take you a day, it'll probably take you a week, it'll probably take you a month, but sooner than later, you will get used to the eerie silence, you will get used to the quietness, you will get used to the stillness of your mind. Once you do this, once this happens, your transformation has already begun. Now, I know nobody can take a month long holiday and do this for that period of time, but doing it for at least an hour or 2 or 3 hours a day, or doing it on the weekends, or getting away on the weekend and doing this on the weekend like you should instead of going out and partying, could be a lot better for your thoughts, could be a lot more clearer for your mind and your soul. This takes time. Getting used to the silence takes a lot of time, but once you master your silence, there won't be any noise distracting you from your goals, your visions, your purposes in life. Get quiet, meditate, do yoga, whatever you can, but this time when you have found yourself to be quiet and still in the place, I want you to totally, absolutely embrace it. Because the chaos that life has to offer is not in your control. It'll never be in your control. You can be in your control, your body, your mind, and your soul can be your control, but your life is just a train wreck of things. If you want to take ownership of it, if you want to take ownership of at least some of the actions you do in your life, you have to first take ownership of yourself. Now, before we get into the step number 4, the very first few things you'll notice happening to yourself when you do this step number 3, which is getting quiet and sitting by yourself, is sleep. You'll actually end up sleeping a lot. You might not be meditative, you might not be aware, you'll just be sleeping all day long. And that's because you haven't really slept in peace for a very long time. So this is a very good time for your body and your mind to catch up on some lost sleep. And once that's done, once your body is fresh and active, we'll go to the step number 4, which is none other than taking charge of your life. Now, how do you take charge of your life? Well, the very first thing, the very basic thing you can do to take charge of your life after you have started embracing the quietness, after you have detached yourself from all the social media and the algorithm influence, after you have become absolutely okay meditating and being in that quiet place, is writing your lists down, writing your goals and writing your tasks down. You can use your smartphone, put it on airplane mode, go to the notepad and write your things down, or you can simply use a pen and paper. I put it on my phone because I have my phone with me all the time, and that's the easiest way for you to get your shit together. Now, I don't want you to overwhelm your to-do task, because now your thoughts are clear. Now you'll be thinking a lot more productive and proactive thoughts, because you're not getting influenced by somebody else's holiday or somebody else's success, because you have been off social media. You have not been influenced by this algorithm. So your thoughts are absolutely yours. They are absolutely crystal clear for your favor. But this does not mean that you will write 100 things that you would want to do in a day. This will only overwhelm you. This will only make you more and more anxious, which is something I don't want. I want you to restrict your to-do list to 2 to 4 tasks a day. Yes, not 10, not 20, not even 100. Just 2 to 4 important tasks of a day. Once you write them down, once you have planned out your day, your week, or even a month, if you're feeling that productive, it's about time you get on it. Gentlemen, the only time, the only way you can actually get to your to-do task, the only way you can actually finish the goals at hand, is when you're totally detached from this influence that you get from the noise around, and when you are absolutely well rested in terms of your body and your mind. If you haven't had a sound sleep, if you're always getting influenced by the algorithm and the BS they feed, you'll never be able to think for yourself. You'll never be able to think clearly what you want, how you want to do things in your life. You'll always be comparing, you'll always be competing, and you'll always be overthinking yourself. When you say you want to reset your life, basically you want to think the right things. You don't want to overthink, you don't want to get anxious, you don't want to be the lazy one who's just not able to take charge and make it happen his or her way. If you really want to make it happen your way, then you have to learn to detach, you have to learn to reset and restart your life your way against the noise. Learn to denoise, learn to accept the stillness and the quietness, learn to meditate, learn to embrace the sleep, learn to repair your mind and body, and write your to-do task, which is for your absolute personal needs. Any sort of influence is only going to distract. Any sort of influence will only make you overthink things. I don't want you to do that ever. I hope this video helps. I hope this video gives you some clarity in getting your stuff done. If you really want to reset your life in many other ways, there are plenty other videos on the channel. You can check them out. And going forward, this is what you can expect from this channel. A lot of personal development, a lot of entrepreneurship, business, and my take on the social issues that I see around, and all the fashion, grooming, and lifestyle related videos could be seen on the other channel, which is kind of my Hindi channel as well, the Mang Bhattacharya TV. In case you haven't, you can check it out as well. My name is Mang Bhattacharya. Gentlemen, thanks a lot for watching. In case you are into men's fashion and style, you can check out my brand. This shirt is by my brand called Teamy Basics. We have our own shoes by Boston Shoes at Teamy Basics. We are coming up with a few other products as well, all for your own personal growth and development. I'll see you in the next one. Jai Hind. Take care. Bye. Price for y'all, snake eyes on dice for y'all, shoulders on ice for y'all.